welcome to episode 17 of the MDQuilter Knits podcast. I'm Beth and I'm your host, and I'm coming to you from the eastern shore of Maryland as always. We're in a little bit of a different area of the yarn room today. This is kind of right here is some of my Fresh from the Cauldron yarn. This is my self-striping yarn. And then this is some more fingering weight yarn. This is all hedgehog fibers here. Yeah, so I thought we'd do a little bit of a different view for a change. I also got a new chair, cute little bicycles on it. So we're going to give this a little try and see if a change of scenery helps me to podcast a little more often. I do apologize for the delay. It has been a minute since I last podcast. I have been crazy busy knitting on things that I haven't been able to show you until now. Knitting some samples that the patterns weren't coming out until this week. So yeah, I was just going to have a whole bunch of, I'm knitting, but I can't show you. So figured I'd wait until I could actually show you what I'm working on. So let's get into it. This is my first FO is my Everyday Marl sweater. And this was a test for Mina Phillip of the Knitting Expat. You guys did see this while it was in progress, but it is now finished. If you follow me on Instagram, which I am MDQuilter there, as well as on Ravelry, but you would have already seen this. A little bit about the sweater. It is a pullover. It can also be steeked as a cardigan. And I chose to use 10 skeins of fingering weight yarn and marl them all together. You can see the full marl on my sleeve. I will also post a photo of me wearing this. It's a little tight quarter, so I can't exactly stand up here and show you, or else everything will come crashing down. The yarn itself is from Fresh from the Cauldron, which are here and a little bit more above as well. And this is the Shudik sock base. And all of the colors are inspired by the show Supernatural. So there's just massively fun speckled yarns in that same theme. So they all go together very well. And I'm super happy with this. And I just can't wait for it to get a little bit cooler here in Maryland so that I can wear it on a regular basis. This will definitely be part of my rotation. The other thing that I have finished is my Ursina. And this sweater is, sorry, it's going to blow out a little bit. But if you look at the bottom, it has this fun half brioche stitch detailing there, as well as on the side seam and down the front. There's kind of a faux seam down the front and on the back as well. This is a lighter weight version of Jackie Cieslak's Ursa. Jackie is the designer. And this particular pattern, you can knit it in sport weight or fingering weight, or I'm sorry, sport weight or worsted weight. She partnered with Magpie Fibers and used Nest. This is the Nest Sport. The color is Twilight Dark. And it also comes in a full length or a cropped version. So the pattern itself gives you four different versions of this sweater. So you get a lot of bang for your buck there. This was super fun to knit. Show you a little bit more of the detailing of that Nest Sport. I apologize for my naked fingernails. I have not had a chance to do them. But I did want to get this episode out to you. So two sweaters all finished right here. And then I knit two more sweaters since I last saw you. And these were samples for Magpie Fibers. And I'll pop up pictures of them here. And I'll pop up even a picture of Damie wearing one of them. This is the Sparky. And the Sparky is the pullover version of the Spark and Spice cardigans that Andrea Mowry designed as her Rhinebeck sweaters. And the Sparky actually released this past week. And there was supposed to be a meetup on the hill for the Spark and the Spice and the Sparky. But Rhinebeck didn't happen this year, so it didn't happen. So that's going to be happening virtually actually a little bit later today. I knit both of these using Magpie Nest Sport and Spin Cycle dyed in the wool. The brown is in a new color that Magpie designed called, the brown is called Evil Beavers at Twilight. And the Spin Cycle color with that is Robin's Egg. And then the other is the natural color of the Nest Sport. It's the undyed natural. And then the Spin Cycle is Magpie's exclusive colorway of Spin Cycle called Birds of a Feather. And these were both a dream to knit. I loved every minute of knitting them. You'll see that there's pockets in both, cute little pockets on the front. And yeah, just that fun potato chippy all over color work. So yeah, so that's four finished sweaters since we last spoke. I've been on quite a bit of a sweater knitting kick. My only other FO is my September Desert Vista Dye Work socks. And that is these. As always, I used the heel toe do-si-do pattern by Kay Litton of Crazy Sock Lady Designs. And the colorway is No Soggy Bottoms, which is a inspired by the Great British Baking Show. And I absolutely love this colorway. Had a blast knitting them. And yeah, so that gave me three of the four quarters of 2020 finished for the Desert Vista Dye Works annual sock challenge. And you'll also notice that the stripes go in opposite directions. I really just wanted to finish these and I didn't want to pull out a full repeat. I kind of misjudged where I was finishing things on the first one. So I just started from the other end of the ball. So the stripes go in different directions, but it's really not noticeable unless I point it out. So yeah. All right, so four sweaters finished and one pair of socks. Yay. So on the needles, what am I working on? I have, this is in my Mrs. Brown's bags. I'm not sure what she calls this, like a medium tote with drawstring. But the fabric is a photo of Lola Bean's A City So Nice They Named It Twice colorway, all knit up. Love this bag style. It's super fun. And in here is the beginnings of my Herbaceous. And this pattern also came out this weekend. This is Jamie Hoffman's newest pattern. Jamie is Knitosophy. I have finished, this is the first chart here, and this is the first half of the second chart. I am in love with this pattern, the colors, but is a fingering weight sweater with a lot of ease. So there's a lot of stitches here, so it's taking me a very long time to get through this color work. The colors that I'm using Leading Men Fiber Arts in their Soliloquy base. And the two colors that I'm using are Heathers and Lightning Bug. So this is Lightning Bug. Sorry. Lightning Bug and Heathers. You'll notice on Heathers, that's a beautiful gray base with lots of fun speckles in there. So yeah, I'm really enjoying this one and I'm looking forward to finishing it. But of course, other things have jumped on the needles as well. But it will get finished, I promise. I will finish it. My other cast on is I am testing the Radvent cardigan for Amba O'Brien. And this is her sweater using an Advent kit. Or just a series of minis. And I am actually using, this is Cloudborn It's the Merino Sock Twist. And it is such a wonderful, soft, it's an 80-20 superwash merino nylon blend. And the color is, I want to say Stone Heather, I believe. Sorry, I forgot to grab the tag. But this is my main color. And then I'm using my Advent kit from 2019 from Woolen Boon. Look at that. So I just started color number 5. This is color number 5. And the style of this sweater, it's knit side to side, and it is a dolman sleeve cardigan, and it's a cropped cardigan. If you're familiar with her Pop Crop Cardi, it's a very similar construction to that. But I am loving this fade. Oh my gosh. And I'm almost done this sleeve. And then I'll start on the body section. And you just knit it from one side in and then from the other side in, and you join them and then do a little bit of magic with a main color. And then you have a finished sweater. So this one is, this project is living in my Wild Strand Studios bag. I actually got this bag, it's really hard to see the color, it's olive colored. And I bought this from Christina of Chelsea Lux, Chelsea Yarns. The inside's got this really cute eyeglass pattern. This is a wonderful heavy canvas bag, just an open tote bag. And it's so, so nice and sturdy and carries a full project. I used this one for when I was knitting the first Sparky sample, the brown Sparky sample. It lived in here through the whole thing. Yeah. So I knit that. I'm also using my brand new Addy Sock Rocket Squared interchangeables, and I love them. They are amazing needles. So glad I sprung for that. So anyway, so I ordered this during the New Jersey Sheep and Wool Festival from Chelsea Yarns, and loved it so much that when Wild Strand did an update, I had to also get it in pink. Is anyone surprised by this? So I also have it in pink, and it's got a nice little like calico type print on the inside. And just look at the grommets. The grommets are rose gold. It's rose gold on the other one too. It's amazing. Okay, so in this one is my last work in progress. And this is my Spark cardigan. I just started the sleeve of it, but I finally got it on the needles. I am so excited. I am using Twilight Beaver for my main color. And Spin Cycle Dream State in the Verba Volant color, which is this beautiful pinks and yellows with this Twilight Beaver colorway. Oh, so, so yummy. I am so excited to be knitting on this finally. So this will be kind of like my work on it when I have a minute type of project. All right, so that's everything that is currently on the needles. What is coming up on the needles? I am gonna be knitting another sample for Magpie. This one is in their Nest Worsted. I'm using the Natural Midnight colorway, which is a beautiful deep chocolate brown. This is just a swatch, just to give you an idea. and I cannot show the pattern. But yeah, this is going to be an amazing, amazing project. And I'm so excited to have the opportunity to knit that for all the Magpie gals. And the last project that's coming up is my October Desert Vista Dyework socks. And I chose for this one my Edward Scissorhands colorway. And there it is, caked up. think it's fitting for October to be doing Edward Scissorhands. And I'll also be doing the heel toe do-si-do pattern as usual. And as always, as well, it's living in my Hohe & Co. BA bag from the original run. I just love this bag so much. It gets better with age. All right. So what else do I have? I have a few acquisitions. I have a lot of acquisitions, but we're just going to talk about a few of the acquisitions. Because it's been so long since I've podcasted, I just don't want to bore you with a whole crazy host of new things that have come in. So first off, we'll talk about, after Ruth Bader Ginsburg passed away, I had for a long time been looking at bags with her likeness on it, but I saw this one. And the pattern, the fabric is actually called the Supremes. And it has Ellen Kagan, Sandra Day O'Connor, Ruth Bader Ginsburg, and Sonia Sotomayor all depicted on here. And the cool thing also, it has a window in it. So this will be just a fun little small shawl, sock, hat, whatever project. But yeah, maybe I'll knit the Descent cowl and put it in here. It could happen. All right. The next thing is Diane of Suburban Stitcher. She was running a sale recently, getting rid of some of her Surrey Silk yarn that's just been sitting there. And I am a sucker for some slimy green. So I got myself two skeins of Surrey Silk. This is 74% baby Surrey alpaca, 26% silk. In the slime colorway. That's a pretty good representation of the color there. Yeah. And I'm actually planning on using this as the lining for some, what are they called? Snuggle socks. That's what it is. Maxim Sir, Max the Knitter, he designed the Snuggle is Real cowl. And then he did some coordinating socks. So I'm going to use this as the lining. And I still have to figure out my two yarns for the outside. But those are going to be like my winter slipper socks for when I'm in here in the yarn room knitting. All right. Next thing that we've gotten, I picked up a kit from Pineapple Yarn. My friend Paula. Hi, Paula. She alerted me to this kit coming up, and I mean, this yarn is just gorgeous. And the colorway is called Sunny Side Up, because it goes with this absolutely stinking adorable project bag that is pink with Sunny Side Up eggs all over it. How could I not get this? That is me personified. So I have no idea what this is going to become. It might wind up being the yoke of a colorwork sweater. You know, pick up a nice, nice color for the mane and use this as the accent for the colorwork sweater. I think that would be super fun. If you didn't know, I am totally in a sweater knitting mode right now. All the sweaters all the time. That's all I can do. All right. The next thing is, unless you've been living under a rock, you know that Stephen West is doing his 2020 Mystery Knit Along. And I could not resist ordering a kit from Stephen and Penelope because I really wanted the goodie bag. So this is the West Knits bag. It will not carry the project because, oh my God, his projects are insane. And then it comes with a couple of little goodies in here. And the kit that I got was the Holst Super Soft. So this oatmeal color down here is the main color. And then these three are the contrasting colors. So it's very pink. And I think I'm going to love it. All right. So what else do we have? So everything else that I've gotten relates to the knit along that Abigail of Covert Knits and I are hosting, which is the Gilmore Along 2020, hashtag Gilmore Along 2020. Knit, spin, crochet, sew, craft, however you want, whatever you want to do, anything inspired by the Gilmore Girls. We're collecting prizes and doing all kinds of fun stuff with that. Abigail, you need to go over and watch the Covert Knits podcast. She has been going to town knitting the Gilmore Girls themed projects. Sadly, I have not even started my first one. We were talking the other night. She's like, well, it's not like you can win prizes, which is true, but I do also still want to knit along, but I've been crazy knitting sweaters. So sadly, it just hasn't lent me to doing that yet, but we'll see what happens. But it has not stopped me from collecting the Gilmore themed products. So I saw this fun kit by the Little Wolf Knits. Look at that. So this is I'm All In and Luke Steiner. Whoops. Let's go that way. There we go. Look at that. And Little Wolf Knits is also a pattern designer. And there was a pattern that came with it called, I want to say, Flannel Shirt Socks. I think I will look it up and put it down below here. But the pattern is super cute, and I'm actually thinking about knitting the socks in the pattern with this yarn. I really like it. It also came with an adorable stitch marker, or progress keeper, which I have sitting over there and just can't reach right now, from Itty Bitty Designs, or Little Bitty Designs. I'll put it down below. But I will pop in a picture of it. It's super cute. It's like a cheeseburger and fries on a plate. And it matches this yarn perfectly. So yeah, so I'm looking forward to knitting that up. That might happen during the knit along. I don't know, anything's possible. And also Ginger Snap that, I think she is. And Area 51 put together a fun kit. Ginger Snap did there's also a progress keeper that I do not have right here. Sorry. Ginger Snap did the bag, and Area 51 did a Welcome to Stars Hollow colorway. This is the Welcome to Stars Hollow color. It matches the bag perfectly. And look at this massive bag. Oh my God, it is huge. And the cool thing, it has that frame on the inside so that it stays open. Wow. I will be using this a lot. Nice long strap so I can carry it over my shoulder. Faux leather bottom. It's just fabulous. And this yarn matches this bag just perfectly. Look at that. And this is self-striping. So it's just going to stripe up in all of these different colors. Whoops. Sorry. Hope y'all are okay. Nobody got hurt after that? All right. Good. Good, good. Okay. The other thing that I have acquired recently are a couple of prizes. Yay! So I love myself a good steel wine glass or tumbler. Sorry, I'm going to just move this. Okay. Either wine glass or tumbler. And Piper Lou has great ones. So I picked up a wine tumbler for you guys that says Honorary Gilmore Girl. Somebody will be getting this at the end of the along. And I also picked up, this one's actually mine. Sorry, I've been using it lots. A yellow Luke Steiner tumbler. So there's another one exactly like this for you guys. Yeah. All right. Yeah, so we've got those prizes. Also, Ginger Snap is going to be sending a prize. I think Little Bitty Delights is also sending a prize. Yeah, I've been getting a lot of prizes. I've been coordinating a lot of prizes, which is fabulous. Also, Area 51 still has the coupon code going where you can save. Let me see. It is a coupon to save 10% off at her shop. That's area51fibers.com, and that's F-I-B-R-E-S. And the coupon code is all in caps, G-G-K-A-L-1-0. And they're also doing a Stars Hollow Fall Festival colorway, which is a special 20 stripe colorway. I got my shipping notice. It's on the way to me. Yeah. And I think she's donating a skein of that as well, to the knit along, which is fantastic. So you guys will win that. Yeah. So definitely enter the knit along. We've had some beautiful entries, several finishes. It is an Instagram only contest, so whether you finish an item or not, it's okay. We're going by entries, not necessarily FOs. So just cast on those prizes that remind you of Gilmore Girls, and it can be coffee themed. A lot of people are doing the Coffee Talk socks, which is Tracy Miller's of the Grocery Girls, her pattern. Perfect. Coffee Talk socks are perfect because it's all about the coffee. Yeah, so be creative. Sell us the story. And just make sure you hashtag your posts on Instagram. And also tag Abigail and myself there. Abigail is at @covert_knits. And I am at MDQuilter on Instagram. So yeah. Definitely get into doing that. Also, don't forget about my year-long knit along is coming to an end, which is the hashtag shop the stash first knit along. This sweater, perfect shop the stash first. I pulled all 10 of these skeins out of deep stash. It made me super happy. So keep knitting along with us. We're having a lot of fun doing all of this. So yeah, I think that's everything right now. It's not a very long episode, but I think we're only at about 27 minutes or so. But yeah, short and sweet and to the point. I had quite a few finishes and I'm glad I got to share them with you. And I'm gonna hope to not be gone so long this next time around. When I don't have anything that I can show you, it's just, I don't feel like y'all really want to just hear me talk about nothing. So yeah. definitely like, subscribe, recommend this to your friends. I have fun talking to you guys. I hope you guys have fun listening to me babble along about my knitting. So keep on knitting, enjoy, and come back in hopefully just a couple of weeks to see what MD Quilter knits next. Bye.